It's named in honor of America's most decorated soldier and Congressional Medal of Honor recipient. Murphy was to have been the guest speaker here at this Spirit of America Festival in 1971, but died in a plane crash just 2 months before his appearance. The award was then named after him and is presented annually to an outstanding American patriot or outstanding group of individuals who best exemplify the spirit of America. This year's recipient of the Audie Murphy Patriotism Award is Decatur's own, the late Lieutenant Colonel Elliot Cecil Chandler. We have a video to describe.
Pro Air Services Incorporated proudly presents the Spirit of America Festival 2013, Audie Murphy Patriotism Award. The Korean War has often been referred to as the Forgotten War, and until a reunion of the 1343rd Engineer Combat Battalion just a few years ago, the heroics of a member of that unit, a Decatur man, were also forgotten. The following is an account of an extract of notes provided by Charles B. Riley, who was a squad leader in Company A of the 1343rd. On May 23, 1951, our company was in charge of building a supply route in support of a South Korean infantry division that was defending the front line north of the 38th parallel in an area called Panglimi. North Korean and Chinese infantry divisions penetrated the South Korean defenses, leaving no friendly forces between us, 150 men, and the enemy, which consisted of hardened infantry soldiers. We observed the South Koreans retreating from their positions, but we were under orders to stay put and maintain the main supply route. Our captain contacted headquarters, requesting permission to retreat because of the impossible situation we were in. Each request was denied by Corps headquarters, and we were ordered to hold or advance. But the situation continued to deteriorate. We would soon be surrounded and in danger of being killed or captured if something didn't change. When the captain called again, our battalion commander was indisposed. Enter our unknown hero, then Major Cecil Chandler, the battalion executive officer. Major Chandler immediately recognized the urgency of Company A's last request to retreat. He gave orders, risking his military career, for us to advance to grid coordinates that were, in fact, to the rear. This moved us away from the advancing Chinese, but in a position to support the retreating South Koreans. Due to his leadership ability, alertness of mind, ability to act under pressure, and compassion for his men, while fully understanding the military risk, he saved all 150 men. No one was harmed. His brilliant actions saved all men and equipment of Company A, of which I was a member. These events have not been revealed before because Major Chandler did not want anyone to know of his actions. He never looked for recognition, but he always delighted in knowing that he made a difference in the lives of 150 men, all from Decatur. Sergeant Riley finished his account by recognizing Major Chandler as a Southern general, true officer, and a quiet, compassionate, Christian man. He saved the lives of men, not with cannon and saber, but with love, compassion, intelligence, and alertness. Today, we salute Lieutenant Colonel Elliot Cecil Chandler as a friend and fellow veteran. The 2013 Spirit of America Festival Committee wants to assure veterans of this war that they are appreciated more than with mere words. We honor one of their own, Lieutenant Colonel Elliot Cecil Chandler, as the recipient of the 2013 Audie Murphy Patriotism Award. The award will be given posthumously to his family.
Presenting the award tonight is Marshall Putman, a decorated Vietnam veteran awarded the Navy Achievement Commendation Medals with the V device for combat valor. Receiving the award for the family is Dr. Stephen Chandler, Elliot's son.